defiled and helpless we, spotless Lamb of God was He. Full atonement, can it be? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Worth the whole realm of nature mine that were oppressed and far too small. Amazing love, how can it be that Thou, my God, the Almighty God, the Son
Alice says, give your sons to die for me. God the Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, gave his son to die for you. Amazing love. How can it be that Thou, my God, would die for me? That's the story of the cross. Well, I'll talk about my sponsors in a minute.
The mighty fortress is our God, a bulwark never failing. Our helper, He amid the flood of mortal ills prevailing. For still our ancient foe does seek to work us woe. His craft and power are great, and armed with cruel hate. On earth is not His equal. Did we in our own strength confide, our striving would be losing. Were not the right man on our side, the man of God's own choosing. You ask who that may be? Christ Jesus, it is He. Lord Sabaoth, His name, from age to age the same. And He must win the battle. And though this world with devils filled should threaten to undo us, we will not fear, for God hath willed His truth to triumph through. The prince of darkness grim, we tremble not for him. His rage we can endure, for lo, his doom is sure. One little word shall fail him. That word above all earthly powers, no thanks to them God. Let goods and kindred go, this mortal life also, the body they may kill, God's truth abideth still. His kingdom is forever. His kingdom is forever. His kingdom is forever and
ever. Amen. Praise the Lord and shame on the devil. Not here. He is risen as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay. Amen. Well, let me give you a little test. You might call this the acid test. Now, that's sort of boring to you if you just got religion and you're more interested in the beat than you are the meat of the message, as old Ed Blue used to say. But if you know the Lord Jesus Christ, understanding what he went through, that we could have these blessed promises, this blessed hope of the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ. Well, that's good for you, all right. That's the bottom line, the cross. And a man called Jesus that was on that cross, that was in the tomb, but he's not anymore. He's seated. He's far above all principalities and powers. Well, you're listening to a program called In the A.M. with the I.M. here. We're getting settled down, getting started off here with a good start, all right? And it's brought to you by L&B Appliances, one of our sponsors, out here at 160 Durkee Road, out here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Now, they've got a telephone number. They can meet all your heating and air conditioning needs. And they're small enough to know you, yet large enough to meet all the needs that you might have. In this hot summer that we're having, but it's supposed to be. This is the good old summertime, all right? They got Maytag, Electrolux, Tempstar, Frigidaire, Manor, Whirlpool, Lydia's dozen. Now, they've got them all. Go by there and visit with them and tell me you heard it here on Whoop Radio on In the AM with the IM. And I would appreciate that. Go by and see Josh and Tim. If you want to go up to Head of Wall, you can see sweet little old Sonia. That's my great niece. And they're up there at Etowah, Tennessee, on Tennessee Avenue, right on the right. Same people, the same good service, all right? Well, let's have another good song. This is one right here that's really needed. Then we're going to change the tempo just a little bit, but not a whole lot. Because this is sort of a somber time. There's just a whole lot of things going on that, it just shouldn't be. I'll have somewhat to say about that so you can turn it up so you sure won't miss it. And I just know you'll like it. This is what people need.
To a world where wrong seems right, what could be too great a cost for sharing life with one who's lost? Through his love our hearts can feel all the grief they bear. They must hear the words of life, only we can change.
Turn to that Lord, that God the Father of the Lord Jesus Christ, the only living and true God. That's one we return to. That's one we've turned our back on. And that's the reason you see the chaos in the streets that we're having today. We're a nation that's forgot God. But New Salem Baptist Church hadn't forgot him. And they're located at 175 Ladd Springs Road, southeast, right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. If you go off APD 40, hit the Spring Place Road. Everyone knows where Spring Place Road. That's Highway 74. And go to Ladd Springs, right down below Macedonia Baptist Church, and take a left, and you look straight ahead. You'll be looking into the center of the New Salem Baptist Church. Go down and visit those folks today, and they'll be preaching messages. It goes right along with these songs I've played this morning. Because I know Brother Cooper, he don't get very far from the cross when it comes to preaching and teaching, and that's what it's all about. That's bottom line. This other stuff, it's a lot of it's good for us to rejoice and praise the Lord, but there's a time and a place for everything. Like the wisest one of all, Solomon told us in the book of Ecclesiastes. That's what he says, time for everything. That's just the way it is. But we're glad that you're listening today. Appreciate it if you'd go by and see our sponsors and tell them you appreciate them for sponsoring this good music that we have. We got another sponsor, too. We have Byers Den Barbecue up here at Ocoee. That's Brother Ed Scoggins and his family visited with them just yesterday. Yeah, yesterday. It was, and got a great place of business up here on the right. And good food, good fellowship, friendly atmosphere, just a great place to go and enjoy the good things that God is sharing with his people. All right, and with all peoples as far as that's concerned. And go by there and visit him. Now, his telephone number is 338-5757. If you want catering, you call 331-7351. That's Ed's personal number. His cell phone is 331-7351, and he'll line you up with all that good food that they have up there. Just normal American food, prepared right, priced right, just right for you. You can eat inside or outside, whichever you would like to do. But go by there and see Ed and tell him you heard it here on the radio. Well, let's hear Whoop Radio, 99.9 on your dial. As I say, the biggest little radio station in the world, right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Well, here's something we need to do, especially in our nation today, is to walk together.
Walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. Walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. Walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. There's a great, great, great camp meeting in the promised land. Well, walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. Walk together, children.
And
don't you get weary. Walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. There's a great,
keep on walking when you're happy. Keep on walking when you're low. Keep on walking through the midnight.
Keep on walking down that long, long road. You gotta walk together, children.
Walk together and go.
Together, children,
don't
you get weary. You gotta walk together, children.
Walk together and
don't you get weary. There's a great, great,
great, great,
great camp meeting in the promised land.
Let's walk the street.
together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. Walk together, children. Don't you get weary. Gotta walk together, children.
Walk together and don't.
Don't you get weary. There's a great,
hey, hey,
great,
hey,
great camp meeting in the promised land.
Boom, 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 boom.
Walk together now.
Boom, 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 boom.
Don't you get weary, child.
Boom, 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 boom.
Almost home.
Boom, boom.
Hallelujah.
I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone.
In my distress, He kindly will help. He ever loves and cares for His own.
I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear these burdens. I must tell Jesus. Jesus can help me. Jesus alone.
I must tell Jesus all of my troubles. He is a kind, compassionate friend. If I but
will help me.
He says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. He's the only way. In religious circles, or Christian circles, whichever you might be in, he has the answer. Father, we come to you this morning, Lord. We thank you for this day. Now, the opportunity we have to come here and share the good news and the good songs that we have that you've inspired folks to write that are truth. The Lord, our hearts, I'm humble today because of all the things that's going on. As Habakkuk said, Lord, in wrath remember mercy. I don't know, Lord, if we've crossed the deadline or not, if there's any hope for our nation is returning to you and for the blessings that you would like to shower up on us, Lord, I just don't know. But, Lord, I come to you in Jesus' name, and, Lord, I've sinned, come short of your glory, fell way short of the mark that you had set for me. I ask your forgiveness, and I thank you for the forgiveness that you have that comes through the shed blood of your dear Son that died on no rugged cross that I might have life and have it more abundantly. But Lord, our nation's in trouble. And as we played the song a while ago, people need the Lord. Father, across this nation today, as your churches gather together in your name, I ask you, Lord, to bless those that hold up the blood-stained banner of the old rugged cross and stay true to your word as we're commanded to be. I ask you to bless them in Jesus' name today. I ask you to comfort our nation. Lord, may we realize that as our documents say, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. But Lord, liberty and justice is not being shared equally. But Father, we know you're the answer. We don't know the way, but we know the one that knows the way, and that's you. So we just submit ourselves to you today, asking to bless our nation, especially our policemen, those that are to keep the peace. May there be a great awakening, Lord, across this land before bloodshed becomes a common thing as it is. Our hope is only in you and not in government, anyone else. But government is just an arm that you use and you set up. So we just submit to you today. We ask that this program goes out in this small town that we live in here today. And this town will join together in unity, one and all. But Lord, not unity at the price of truth. Your word's truth. Your word will stand when the world's on fire. It will abide forever. May we return to the principles of your word. Your blessings have been so great upon us, especially in our city and our town. And Lord, we thank you for that today. Thank that we've got the right to assemble today and proclaim the mercies of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. May that not be taken away. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name.
What this dying world could use is a willing man of God, who dares to go against the grain and works without applause.
A man who raised that shield of faith, protecting what is pure, whose love is tough and gentle, a man whose word is sure. God doesn't need an orator who knows just what to say. He doesn't need authorities to reason him away. He doesn't need an army to guarantee a win. He just needs a few. And derelict whose life has been renewed. He calls the one who has the strength to stand up for the truth. Enlist, the lines are open, and he wants you to come in. He just needs a few good men.
Not a time for pantyhose preachers with lace on their drawers. It's time we, men of God, stand up and preach, thus saith the word of God, without an apology. Just tell it like it is and let it stick. If the cat don't like it, the cat can turn around. Stick with this book, the old rugged cross, Jesus is Lord.
Children form a parade with a flag bearer leading the way. Farmers and teachers, the old and the young, lift together their voices to say,
I pledge my allegiance to the grand old flag and the promise of hope from sea to sea. Under God, one nation, undivided, we will stand, lift the banner.
It's the final kickoff for the NFL, and the stadium is packed with screaming fans. All the banners are flying, the color guards advance. Like a wave, silence moves through the stands.
I pledge my allegiance to the grand.
Till there's justice.
Glory, hallelujah. his bosom that transfigures you and me. And as he died to make men holy, let us live to make men free.
For God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. It's true, it's marching on. It's true, it's marching on.
Yeah, his truth will always march on. All right. My mom used to say the truth will stand when the world's on fire. Okay. Well, I about forgot about our sponsors playing all this good music I got for you today. It's sort of summertime, but that's all right. Janine Chastain's got a little place down here at Five Point. Makes all kinds of sweets. And she's just a sweet lady. And all the things that she has satisfy your sweet tooth. Go down there and visit with her. It's an experience in Old Town Cleveland, Five Point Cafe, located at Five Point, old Five Point drugstore of many, many, many years ago when I was a boy, okay? And that's been a while. Go by there and see the good food she has and good fellowship. Just a great place to go and enjoy yourself. Enjoy the good things that God's made and the people that God gives gifts and have talents to minister to others, and that's what it is, and that's just what they do. Go by there and visit with them. Then if you're going up toward Ocoid, go to Bear's Den Barbecue. Just all kinds of good places that you can enjoy the great blessings and overflow from the blessings of salvation and just have a great time. It's always good to have fellowship around food. And you can have that with Brother Ed and his wife and his family. It's a family-oriented thing, just like Five Point Cafe is. Just like Whoop FM is here on the radio. It's just one big family, and that's what it's all about. It's about family, faith, friends, food, future, and fun, okay? Got to get that in there. Even in times like this, there's joy, because our hope's not in the circumstances around us. Our hope's in the Lord, and that's that blessed hope. All right? It's sure. All right? That's just the way it is. That's the reason we can laugh and cry at the same time and know that it's going to be all right in the end. All right? And New Salem Baptist Church will be preaching about that today, as you gather together with them. But Robin's Nest and Bobby's Roost out in Arkansas, exclusive dealer of Arthur's Art, and you can go on Facebook at Robin McCracken Meacham, and you can see the beautiful stuff that she has and some of the stuff that Arthur's Art produces. You can see that, and that would just be great. 501-283-7775, okay? Well, it's not going to be long till the Solid Rock Hour, and we'll be getting along with it in just a little while. But don't forget about L&B Appliance. This summer, boy, I thank the Lord every day for air conditioning, don't you? Don't know how we did it when I was a boy and didn't have it, but it's a great thing. And L&B Appliance at 160 Dura Key Road can meet all your heating and air conditioning needs, no matter what it is. And they've got appliances of all kinds, all the brand names they have. So go by there and visit with them and tell them you heard it here on Whoop Radio, the biggest little radio station in the world, and we're live at the Village Green in the Green Room. Now, let me give you their number. 339-3231. 339-3231. Located at 160 Durkee Road, Northeast, right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. All right? Well, I got another song I want to play for you. This is, I like this one. I'll send this one out to Brother Orr, Brother Cooper's musical director out at New Salem Baptist Church. He likes this song. I do too.
Problem that you
That's right. In a nation that the Supreme Court's been hijacked, FBI's been hijacked, IRS has been hijacked, the justice system has been hijacked, it's time that a lot of folk know this right here. Not me, the government, or me, the president. We, the people.
When the sun comes shining, and I was strolling, and the wheat fields waving, and the dust clouds rolling, as the fog was lifting, a voice was chanting, this land was made for you and me.
Nation, modern times, like this nation, built on these principles. That all men are created equal and that are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, of which is love, which is life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Okay? Well, it's time for the Solid Rock Hour. That's a program dedicated to rightly dividing the word of truth and magnifying the Lord Jesus Christ, the rock of our salvation. Not trying to be politically correct, but be biblically correct. And solid is a rock because he's the rock of our salvation. That's Jesus. That's that name that, it's just not supposed to be, it's just not popular today. Everybody can talk about God, but there's all kinds of gods, but listen, there's just one Jesus. Yep. That's him. And this is what he did. I like this. Now, this is my old brother Cooper.
Jesus is praying in the garden. Our Lord is praying. Yahweh, Jesus is praying. Let this pass from me. Let this pass from me. Yahweh, Jesus is dying.
Say the greatest event that's happened so far is the resurrection of Jesus, the man Jesus. The next great event is when he comes after those that have believed on him from Pentecost to the rapture. That's the catching away of the saints. That's the bride of Christ, okay? Israel, the unfaithful wife of Jehovah, but the church is the bride of Christ, all right? Well, Isaiah means the Lord shall save, all right? The Lord, that's Jehovah, the self-existing one, the promise-filling, unchangeable one. That's him. That's the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the Father of the Lord Jesus Christ, the author of this book and what this book is about. All right. Look what it says here. Let me read this to you again. You've probably heard me read it before, but I feel like I need to read it today. I don't know what I'm going to say, but it'll be all right. Be no apologies made. I'm not a politically correct preacher. Wouldn't know how to be if I wanted to be. Okay. Hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Lord hath spoken. That's that Jehovah. That's the one that stepped out on nothing and made everything, you know. I listened last week. That orbiter, it's orbiting around, what is Jupiter? And some fool said, it might be that we'll find where we started. We'll find the creation of man, where we got started. Well, if you're not an idiot and you've got an IQ of over 5, You read this book, you'd find out where we started. In the beginning, God. Everything after its own species, that's never changed. Hasn't changed. They haven't found the missing link. They've lost the chain, okay? But I know the chain. It's in this book. We're trying to improve upon what God said for 7,000 years, and look what shape we're in. But hear, O heavens, and give ear, O earth, for the Lord has spoken. I've nourished and brought up children, and they've rebelled against me. Yep. The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel doth not know. My people doth not consider. And history repeats itself, doesn't it? We don't know. Well, some of us know. But some don't consider. They don't think. They don't rationalize. They don't realize. They don't speculate. They don't get in this book and know. Ah, sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. Would you think that this nation would stoop as low as it is today? That a pervert has more rights than honest, upright citizen who raises his family or her family according to the teachings of this word. And yet a pervert would have more rights than they had in this so-called Christian nation. And would you think in 8 years how much that perversion has been promoted by our government? Our government has become the corrupter of this nation. You like that or not, doesn't matter a whole lot to me. I decided to go with this book. This is a sinful nation. A people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward. Now, he's talking about his people. He's talking about those that knew God. Man didn't start out in the cave dragging the woman around by the hair of the head with a club in his hand. No, man started out knowing the thrice holy God and having fellowship with that thrice holy God in the cool of the day, in the spiritual part of the day. Adam communed with God. Yeah. Yeah, he's smarter than, we are. And Noah named all animals, didn't he? Yep. All right. Pretty well off. But when we rebel against that known God, we have a nation like we have today. And the nation Israel was a picture of that in this book. Why should you be stricken anymore? Yeah. Do you want more of the same? Do you want more marching in the street? More policemen being shot? Yeah. Peaceful demonstration, they say. Black lives matter. Sure they matter. Blue lives also matter. Every life matters. But your freedom ends when it encroaches on mine. Now, I was just thinking, and it's wrong. I have to get an attitude adjustment every once in a while. But I just, in my old Irish-American way, if I was coming down the road in 18-wheeler and here comes a bunch of folk running out in the middle of the road. See, that's my rights. That's my right of way. Now, old McCracken way of doing it, I'd put that thing to the floor and jam it up in high gear and step on the gas and not let off. If it got out of the way, that'd be all right. If it didn't, that'd be all right, too. Now, that's not the right way, but that's my. I'm telling you, that's this flesh. Yeah. That's his flesh. But how about that? The Black Panthers, this fellow that shot these cops, he's a member of the Black Panthers. Of course, they're going to play that down because Black Lives Matter is an arm of our Democrat Pardon Day, sponsored by George Soros and the Liberal Democrats. Now, you can like that or not. Doesn't matter if you like that or not. That stay is said. There'll be no apologies made for what I say today, by the way. They're corruptors, evildoers, inventors of evil things. Yeah. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. Wasn't born fools. And the context of that is all this perversion we have today. Then the last verse, and that says they're worthy of death. Well, that's where they're going anyway. The second death. When it be said, depart from me, you workers of iniquity, I never knew, doing all this in the name of peace. And the Reverend Al Sharpton, and the Reverend Jesse Jackson. That's the reason I don't want you to call me Reverend. As long as you call them Reverend, don't call me Reverend. They're reprobates. All right, once you be stricken, you revolt more and more. The whole head is sick, and the whole heart is faint. In the last 8 years, ever part of our government has been politicized. Every branch of it is. How they get away with it? Because of the color of their skin. We're supposed to be colorblind. Yeah, that's what they want us to believe. And we elected a black president who's supposed to have been the great uniter, but he's been the great divider. Everyone was pulling for him, hoping against hope that all this racial divide now finally was over. America had repented and turned, and we had a black president. He is half black, but that's all right. And everyone hoped it'd be good, but he split Americans against Americans. The worst that has ever been. Now, I told you, I'll make no apologies. And it's been justice according to the color of the skin now for 8 years. That's the way it is. Like it or not, that's it. And we, as the men of God, have been afraid to say anything. We've got our hands tied. First thing they'll say, well, you're a racist. Well, it's racist in reverse, and this chaos that we have in the streets. Another policeman, understand, was shot last night. Terrible time in America. Why? We've turned our back upon the living and true God. And the Bible says the nation that forgets God will be turned into hell. That's why we're being turned into. We're heading for a race war. If things don't change, we're headed for a race war. That's what some want. Chaos in the streets. And what Miss Clinton got away with this week because she was a woman and because she's run for president is a shame and abomination in the sight of God. Were she a Republican or a conservative, she'd be wearing an orange jumpsuit. But no, she's a Democrat and a woman and a baby killer. Yeah. So she gets off with a smack on the wrist. And we're just about dumb enough to elect her president. Well, let me change that. God says he's in charge of that. We may deserve just exactly that. What we got now, we earned it by turning against a true and a living God. Everything we have done provokes that God. Yeah. Well, our biggest problem is not Muslims. It's not the Black Panther Party. It's not the Democrat Party, although they hate everything God's for. Let me say that again. Everything God's for, the Democrat Party's against. Oh, they go in the guise of how they love people. It's all about power. It's all about a vote. But the reason all this is we've turned against that thrice holy God. And listen, as I started to say, our enemy is not the Black Panthers. Nope. It's not the Muslim. This nation's worst enemy right now is God. Yeah. We've provoked a thrice holy God. Isaiah called him holy, holy, holy. The Lord God Almighty. That's who we've put our fist up in there in his face. Like the Black Power movement now, and Miss Clinton got that on her, the hashtag on her website now, Black Power, a fist. Yeah. That's what we've done to God. We've provoked that living God and true God by our evil deeds. And men love darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. We've transgressed against the things that we've called good evil and evil good in this nation. Knowing better. See, this nation was founded on the principles of the Word of God. Freedom of worship. Yeah. Free enterprise. Now that's the reason this nation was. You know why North America has flourished and South America hasn't in the past century or so? Because South America was founded by folk looking for gold. North America was founded. Folk that wanted God and the worship of God. Freedom to worship. Not a state church where the state dictated what we worshiped and who we worshiped. But no freedom for you to worship that living and true God according to this Word of God. That we have right here. Now look what he says. From the sole of your foot even to your head, there is no soundness in it, but wounds and bruises and putrefying sores. They've not been clothed, neither bound up, neither mollified with ointment. No, you just watch it. It's just putrefying sores. Shameful things happening all around us. Exposed. God's let it be exposed that we might see how evil it is. I wonder when we're going to get sick of sin. When are we going to get sick of chaos? When are we going to get sick of politicians instead of men? Yeah. By the way, let me say this. This fellow up here in Benton, I forget what his name is, running for something. I double dog dare you to prove one thing he's saying that is wrong. All right, check it out. Check his message out. Not one thing is he saying that is wrong. I've listened to it. I've heard it. That's my kind of man. You know why? Because he's not afraid to go against the grain. He's not trying to be politically correct. He's just being correct. Now, you can like it or lump it. Don't matter to me now. I mean, there's a line drawn, and I've drawn one in the sand. I ain't a backing up. And taking no more. All right? From the sole of the foot even the head, there is no soundness in it, but wounds and bruises and putrefying sores. They have not been closed, neither bound up, neither mollified with one. Your country is desolate. Your cities are burned with fire. Does that sound like today? Now listen, let me do a little prophesy. It's not really me. I've heard it before by another man. He had this vision of American cities on fire. You know when they're going to really burn these cities down? When they run out of money, when the socialists spend all the money and the welfare checks don't go out, they'll burn these cities of America if we stand that long. They'll burn them. And the police force by then will have their weapons taken away from them, and they'll just have to stand by and let her burn. And that's the reason they won't take our guns from us, so when they come to the suburbs, us folk won't have no defense. That's chaos. Yeah. That's where we're heading. They'll be burned. No, it's just about like that now. In fact, I watched this morning, those demonstrators, those peaceful protesters, yeah. They're bomb-like firecracker in amongst the policemen this morning. You know what the policemen had a right to do? Mow them down. Yeah. That's a danger. No respect. And these folk, they'd end up getting shot and trouble, and when it all comes down to it, we'll find it'll be their fault. They've got a list as long as your leg. But they've got away with all these years. Finally, it catches up with them. And then you bleeding hearts go and, hands up, don't shoot. Yeah. That's a lie. Built on a lie. Yet it's promoted by our government. They forget about this book. Your country is desolate. Your cities are burned with fire. Your land, strangers devour it in your presence. No borders. Bring them on in. Get them on welfare, free health care, because we love them. No, you know what they're wanting? Another vote. Yeah. Every illegal alien get here, they'll get the vote. Yeah. And all these millions that we've got here now, I can just hear somebody like Charles Schumer say, well, we've got these folk here now, and we've given them a right to a green card and citizenship. It's just not right if we don't let them vote. Now, the Democrat vote. Now, am I not telling it like it is? Now, folk, I may be a liar, and everybody you know may be a liar, but this book is right. This book is right. It is desolate, as overthrown by strangers. And the daughters of Zion is left as a cottage in the vineyard, as a lodge in a garden of cucumbers, and a besieged city. That's how we feel. The average citizens today just sort of feel helpless. Yeah. What's good in it? There's no, we've given up hope. We're just a besieged city. We're surrounded by evildoers. With putrefying sores not bound up, cannot be embarrassed, shameless. We're just surrounded by, and the American family that loves the Lord and loves his family and loves his country just wants to give up hope. Our judicial system is broken to the core. Listen. Except the Lord of hosts had left us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom and we should have been as Gomorrah. Now, it's talking about Israel here. So unless there's a remnant, there's a few of the elect always around, God's going to, he's going to have his people. Who was it? Elijah said, Lord, it's just me. I'm by myself. No one cares but me. Or it's Elijah. Said, there's thousands that haven't kissed Baal. Haven't bowed before Baal, the god of Baal. You're not by yourself. They're out there. They just need to speak up. Be like Sodom and Gomorrah. Boy, that's a pretty scene, wasn't it? That's what we're like today. Even Lot, that just man, willing to give his daughters over to those perverts to do as they wanted to do with them. Yeah. That's the condition that we've gotten in. Hear the word of the Lord, you rulers of Sodom. Give ear unto the law of God, you people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifice unto me, saith the Lord? I'm full of burnt offerings, of rams and a fed beast, and I delight not in the blood of bullocks or of lambs or of goats. When you come to appear before me, who hath required this of your hand to tread my courts? Bring no more your vain oblation. Incense is abomination unto me. The new moons of the Sabbath, the calling of assemblies, I cannot. Away with. It is iniquity. Even the solemn meetings. Now that's you liberal churches. And we've got them everywhere today. There's not enough preaching going on to make an atheist mad. It's religion without a reality or without a relationship to the true and living God. Because those of the true and living God, they hold up this book, this Bible. Yeah. Now, I've got the King James Version here in my hand. It's the best that's ever been. Some may explain a few things a little better. But when you're rightly divided, he's got it just right. Got it just right. But he's sick and tired of our meetings. We've got everything today but God. You go to the churches today, it's like going to cheap restaurants. You go to one, you wish you'd went to the other. We've got preaching. Some is just as straight as a gun barrel, but just as empty. The presence of God is just not there. Maybe the restrainer has been taken away. I don't know. Maybe the restraint of the Holy Ghost is being withdrawn gradually. When have you heard about folk getting together and having an old-time camp meeting? How long has it been since you heard about a soul-saving revival? True repentance, turning from the world, turning to God the Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and churches that have this presence of God. If you've got his presence, that's what you need. That's what's needed today. It'll only come. Now listen, he's only going to visit his people when we forget about ourselves and get our mind upon him and in ministering truth and ministering this word as it's written. Don't need to change the word. We need to change to match this word. But in spite of all this, all the indictments that he had against these folk here, look at the long-suffering of the Lord. If I was him, I'd have wiped this nation off of the book a few years ago. We started down that road. Clinton kicked it in high gear. We haven't got it stopped yet. We're going down the miry side of the mountain on the slick side of the slope. And we see what it's doing to our families, to our nation, and yet we go right on. Whose side are you on? Whose side are you on? But listen to what he says. After all that, he says, come now. Let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If you be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. But if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured with the sword, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. He's more long-suffering than I am. I didn't it a long time ago. But he will in his own time. But he said, come now and let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. He said, if you'll just turn and repent, yeah, he's the God of mercy. Repent of self. Repent of sin. Turn to God through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. Jesus is Lord. There's one mediator between God and men, the man, Christ Jesus. Yeah. That's him. We're narrow-minded enough to say, and the preachers that are preachers and the churches that are churches still say there's just one way. Yeah. And Jesus is that way. The rest of them's out of business, and he's God. He's sick of your new moons and your celebrations and your meetings, your solemn assemblies. He's not there. Yeah. And a lot that think he is there is not. All right. Well, I'm through singing now. There'll be no apologies. No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. If it hurt your puny feelings, I'm sorry. You're really a nice guy, and I didn't mean to say that. But listen, here's bottom line. This is what it's all about right here. The greatest thing that happened so far. And those that know him, this is what they preach and teach. This is a theme, the heart of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yahweh, Jesus is coming in a manger. Our Lord is coming. Yahweh, Jesus is coming, born in Bethlehem. Born in Bethlehem. Yahweh, Jesus is teaching in the temple. Our Lord is teaching. Yahweh, Jesus is teaching. No one speaks like him. No one speaks like him. Hosanna, he comes in the form of.
You needed to hear that again, all right? And you need to hear this one right here also, all right? Hey, we're moving right along here in the AM with IM. Brother McCracken coming to you here on WhoopFM.com and 99.9 on your dial right here in Cleveland, Tennessee.
Saints of all the ages fill its ranks. For the sands of time they're marching to the King's great coronation. And this could be the dawning of that day.
Let me give our sponsors a plug here before we go any further. By the way, now don't hold anything I might say against my sponsors. If they don't like what I say, hey, I got more sponsors than I've got time, okay? So that ain't no problem, but there'll be no problem, all right? That's Helen B. Appliance out here to Highway, just off Highway 64 on Durkee Road. In fact, it's 160 Durkee Road. They got all the brand names of appliances, and service is just great. I know. I have experienced that service, and they did me a great favor, saved me a bunch of money after I had already spent a bunch of money. Didn't take them about 15 minutes to do it. The experts couldn't do it, but Tim said, I got a man to fix anything. I said, well, have at it. About 15 minutes, it's all over. Running just fine, has been now for months. That's the kind of folk they are. That's the L&B appliance. 160 Durr Key Road. All the brand names, don't even name them, they've got them all. Telephone number, 423-339-3231, okay? All right, then there's Janine Chastain. Now, she's got all those appliances down there cooking on her, cooking up those good chocolates and those sweets with all those nuts in it. And by the way, she's got some good, healthy food for you, all right? Well, if we'd just bless it and sanctify it by the word of God and prayer, we'd just eat anything, all right? I don't know about pig's feet. Now, that don't turn me on. But Janine's got it going on down to Five Point Cafe, all right? Just like Byers Den Barbecue up at O'Coy's got it going on. And I tell you, he specializes in that pulled pork. Got pizzas. And, too, he's got soft-serve ice cream. I was up there just yesterday. And he is telling me he had that soft-serve ice cream. So that's good for your sweet tooth also. We just got you covered any way you want to go, anything you want to do. Enjoy the great things God has given us and things that we can enjoy, okay? Well, let's see. The New Salem Baptist Church will be going on here in a little while. And it'll just be great. And they'll be together today. And they'll be raving and boasting about God. That's Jehovah God. He's called the Amen.
Everybody sing.
Let me start that again now.
Amen. Everybody sing. Amen. 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 Sing it over one time, children.
So be it.
Now listen to my story. It's a story about my Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Now we see the little baby. We know that he's wrapped in a manger. How many of you know the story? One Christmas morning. Amen. Amen. See him at the seashore, talking to the fishermen. You know that he's making us disciples. Hey, amen, amen, amen. Riding to Jerusalem as they wave the palm branches. Come on. In the pomp and splendor, we just welcome him and thank him for being in our presence tonight. Amen. If we see him in the garden, praying to his Father, you're in deepest sorrow. Let me for then they crucified him. But he
He's the Amen. He's the beginning and the end. And all that's in the middle. Well, this is Scott Brown. Got acquainted with Scott a week or so ago, and he's got some great songs out. All right. This is one of them right here. He pastors the Cowboy Church down in Appleson, Tennessee.
This is the day that we've been waiting for. I give you my life, it's not mine anymore. You've already taken my heart from me. Here is the rest, I give it willingly. Today,
today,
I make
this vow to you.
To hold
whatever we go through.
Fate could not have put us together like this. God had a plan, and here it is. Today,
I make
this vow to you.
I do, I can't believe my ears. 'Cause you are the one I prayed for all these years. For better or worse, for richer or poor, till death do us part, our love will endure.
Today,
I make this vow to you. To hold whatever we go through. Fate cannot have put us together like this. God had a plan in the air.
How about this one?
Mm-hmm.
Every once in a while I get the feeling that I'll never make it. It comes on so strong and it lasts so long, I wonder if I can take it. And I remember a promise, I have a future and a hope. If I'm gonna follow this one, like I'm not worthy. But his love is strong and it lasts so long, picks me up in a hurry. And I remember his plan, it is for good and not disaster. If I'm gonna follow, I keep my eyes.
Us. We hold to his word. He holds us, gives us rest.
In a world where he's calling you down to a battle to fight on the enemy ground, a war that we're not meant to fight, by the enemy's terms, but the power of his might, there is a rest for the people of God. When we fight the good fight, believing in his word, there is a rest for the people of God. And he was tempted in all things, yet without sin, so with boldness we may enter in. I believe in a coming reward.
have died to the things of this world. In our own strength, we only take pride. But we must walk in the power that He will provide. There is rest for the people of God. When we fight the good fight, believing in His word, there is a rest for the people of God. He was tempted in all things, yet without sin. So with boldness we may enter in. There is a rest for the people of God. And when we fight the good fight, believing in His word, there is a rest for the people of God. He was tempted in all things, and yet without sin. So with boldness we may enter in. And there is a rest.
It's not a rest from the storm. He gives us rest in the storm, all right? Well, it's going to be time for the North Cleveland Baptist Church here in just a few moments. Don't forget our sponsors, Robin's Nest and Bobby's Roost and Arthur's Art. And New Salem Baptist Church, Five Point Cafe, Janine Chastain, Bars Den Barbecue, the Ed Scoggins and his family, and the Tim and Josh Taylor out here at L&B Appliance. They are sponsors for today, all right? Well, it's going to be here in just a few seconds. It'll be time for them. Let's see what this old board looks like up here. Yep, it's just going to be a little while. Hey, we'll see you Wednesday evening here on WhoopFM.com and 99.9 on your dial right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Hope that you'll tune us in and visit with us, and we'll just have a great time together. All right. Well, let's see if I can get in sync here with the radio station, and we will see you then. All right.
It seemed like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your Your name is great and Your heart.
worship your holy name.
We bow with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, that we have so many reasons to sing your praises this morning. We have so many reasons, Lord, to have joy and excitement about being in the house of the Lord and giving you glory and honor this morning. Lord, we pray that this morning you would receive the glory from what we do here, Lord, that it would be for your honor and your honor alone. Lord, that as we stand together and we lift up our hearts and our voices to worship you, that we would connect with your throne this morning. Lord, that we wouldn't leave here the same way that we came, but we would be transformed by the renewing of our mind, by the power of the Holy Spirit in us, by the fresh anointing that you pour out on us this morning. We thank you, God, and we praise you, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. Before you're seated, will you shake a few hands and welcome someone to church this morning? You may be seated as you're finished. Welcome to North Cleveland Baptist Church. We're so excited to have you with us, worshiping together. We just ask that at this time you would you got a special edition evangel, I believe, as you came through the door this morning. That has a little bit longer shelf life on it. It has all the events that are coming up for the next several weeks. Take those home with you. Take a few with you. Hand them out. And the registration slip should be with that. If you'll fill that out at this time, our ushers will be by at the end of service to pick those up. Once again, we welcome you to service this morning, and we just pray that you will get a blessing this morning as we're all together worshiping the Lord.
Perhaps somewhere in the last day or two, you've seen a distinction of the holidays that honor those in our armed forces. Veterans Day to recognize those who have served in the military, Armed Forces Day, those who are currently serving in the military, and Memorial Day for those who have died in service while serving in our nation's military. It has been a custom in our church on Memorial Day Sunday to remember those from our church family who in the past year have gone home to be with the Lord, a memorial to them. And they may not have served in our nation's armed forces, but they did serve in God's army, and they did serve in God's kingdom. And so we pause today to remember, to give thanks, to celebrate their lives, and that they have received an honorable discharge into God's eternal kingdom. And so to quote Lincoln at Gettysburg, it is altogether fitting and proper that we do this. 12 names of those who we have said heartfelt goodbyes to from our church family in the past year. Remember them as I share their names. Virginia Davis, Ruby Simmons, Steve Balding, Helen Ratcliffe, Murray Kinchin, Ralph Harris, Barbara Varnell, Dolores Clymer, Leona Watson, Jean Cannon, Catherine Gamble, and Glenn Mason. Would you bow with me for a word of prayer? Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out before us. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Heavenly Father, we thank you for those who have made up the cloud of witnesses in our lives individually and in our congregation. We thank you for their lives, and we remember their families in this season, in this first year, for so many dates and significant days passed by where their absences felt especially deep. May we be comforted by an eternal home we know that you have prepared for us. And may we claim the word of the psalm that says, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his saints. In your name, amen. Now I'd like to invite our boys and girls who want to join me here at the front for our message to the children. Come stand here at the front of the stage with me. Here we go, guys. guys. Good to see you this morning. A lot of our families are traveling here, but I'm glad you're with us today. And I brought some emojis to show you here that kind of show how we're feeling on the inside, okay? So let me see if I can get them in the order I need them to, okay? What about that one right there? What is that? Is that happy? Do you ever feel happy? What makes you happy? I hear somebody in the peanut gallery saying s'mores. Is that you, Kevin? Okay. It make you happy? Good food make you happy? Playing make you happy? School's out makes you happy? All right, there's a lot of things to be happy for. How about this one? What's that one? Silly. Do you ever get silly? What makes you silly? Somebody tells a funny joke. Is that silly? Or something funny happens? Somebody tickles you? Is that silly? Okay, I didn't get that. How about this one right here? What's this? Huh? What's this one feeling? What's this one feeling? Love. You ever feel in love? Twitter baited? Maybe. Stay tuned, folks. It'll happen in time. How about this one right here? What about this one, though? Sad. Do you ever feel sad? Oh, what makes you sad? Okay, when you miss out on a treat? Okay. How about when you're sick? Does that make you? Or when somebody you care about sick or hurt? Or sometimes when somebody dies? That can make us sad, too. Okay, that is a sad thing. This is what Memorial Day is about. We're remembering those folks who have passed away on to heaven. But we miss them. That's a sad thing. And while we're happy for them to be with Jesus, we have to admit it's a little sad in our heart today. But we're grateful that God has made a way for us to live in heaven with Him forever. Let's bow together for a word of prayer, okay? Thank you, Lord, for loving us and caring for us and bringing things into our life that make us happy and feel silly and make us feel love and to give love. And when we're sad too, Lord, we know you promise that you'll be with us still and you'll watch over us and take care of us. In your name we pray. Amen. Thanks, guys.
How deep, how great, how vast, how mighty is the love of God for us. So much so that he sent his son to die on the cross for us. Would you stand with me as we sing, How Deep the Father's Love?
How deep the Father's love for us. How vast beyond all
salvation. Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart. His sins have paid my
solo up here for a minute. Let us pray. Almighty God, we have come together today to seek your face, to remember the fallen, and to honor their sacrifice. Lord, may we never forget how we became the land of the free and the home of the brave. We look forward, Lord, to a world where sacrifice is no longer needed. For Isaiah the prophet wrote of the mountain of the Lord, then they will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation will no longer take up sword against nation, and they will no longer learn how to make war. Go with us now, Father, teaching us to lead, guide, and direct in all we do for your name's sake. For this is our duty. This is our charge. This is our faith. Let us return to you now, Lord, a portion of what you have given to us. May it always be our first fruits so that we will give our best to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
count it all joy, distracted by the noise, just trying to make sense of all your promises. Sometimes I gotta stop, remember that you're God and I am not. So
to you, when I thought about in this series of sermons on marriage and showing all those wedding photos that you sent me, my intention was just to pull them out at random and cover them all until they had all been covered. But I changed my mind for this week, and I individually picked out the 9 couples that you saw there, and maybe you caught on to the theme that was with each one. In those pictures, one of the partners has married their husband or their wife, and they have seen the depth of grief. I've stood over a lot of gravesides burying husbands and wives and understood the love that is expressed there as a covenant has come to a close as long as we both shall live with the testimony that is shared there. Memorial Day is a time that was dated back to right after the Civil War, Declaration Day first, to honor those who have passed away, who had died in the service in the armed forces. But we have expanded to some degree, not to leave appropriately so the emphasis on our military, but expanded to some degree a time to remember all of our loved ones who have contributed to our life and our welfare, our heritage, and our stories, and show loving tribute to them. This morning, I want you to go with me to a little-known story in the Old Testament book of Ezekiel. It is one of the lesser-known husband-wife stories in all of the Bible. Ezekiel and Mrs. Ezekiel lived in Jerusalem about 600 years before Jesus' birth. It was a difficult and troubling time. It was when the Babylonian Empire was emerging on the forefront of the stage of world powers, and they came through Judea, and they defeated the Hebrew people, and they took some of their leadership with them captive to live in exile in Babylon in several different waves. And among the first of those taken captive and forced to live in exile in Babylon were Ezekiel and his wife. And there Ezekiel was a prophet of the Lord to God's people in a land far from their homeland. And oftentimes, if you're familiar with his messages, he was not the prophet of good news, but he was the prophet of very difficult news for God's people to hear. He spoke God's words, but some ways Ezekiel is also known as well for his actions. You know, the saying is actions speak louder than words, and he accompanied a lot of his messages to his people with some unique and some might even say bizarre messages or bizarre actions to accentuate his messages. And I'll give you some renderings behind me that you can see. In one occasion, he laid on his left side for 390 days and on his right side for 40 days, each day representing a different year that the people of the faith, people of Hebrews, had rebelled against God. On another occasion, he cut all of his hair off, and he cut all of his beard off, and he took the hair, weighed it out into three different equal amounts. One he burned, one third he tossed into the wind, and one third he took a sword and chopped it into little pieces, to say to the people that devastation is going to continue to come. A third will die in famine, a third will die as they are scattered, and a third will die by the sword. On another occasion, when the folks were hoping that the exile would be short and they would get to go home soon, he put all of his belongings out in front of his house, and he dug a little hole there as if to crawl out, not the normal way, and carried his belongings around with him as if one in exile who was already in exile, to say the exile isn't over. It's going to last.